Tell that stupid Swiss to watch his back.
Hey, what's a little extortion among friends?
He hears voices in his head. Don't worry, they're good people.
You there. Keep your head down and come here. Hope you're not looking for passage off the island. The crew's on shore leave, see? The permanent kind. Probably tripped over a few of them on the way in. Poor bastards. Ugly business. A deal gone bad. I work for an orc boss named Kartag. We're ropefish. People smugglers. Slaves pay us out the arse for a trip to the mainland. When the Kamana Tong found out, they wanted in. Kartag told them to tusk off. Yeah. Came down on us like an arse-branded ogre. We gave as good as we got. It wasn't enough. Kartag and a few slaves fled to the cavern. Kamana gangsters right behind. Without help, they're as good as dead. Don't suppose you're the heroic type? Doing this, mate. Kartag's an idiot, but he doesn't deserve what the Kamana Tong will do to him. Like I said, he went in with some slaves. Mabker, Jari Ito, and Wiwaska. You should drag them out, too. He should have made a deal. What kind of rock-headed dunce tell the Kamana Tong to eat their own small clothes? These aren't common hoods. The Tong will feed you to the slaughterfish for a hard glance, let alone insulting their mothers. Moloch knows. I mean, the Tong did have some ideas Kartag wasn't wild about. Upping the prices, chaining up the slaves en route, packing them into smaller ferries. Kartag refused to even consider it. Great time to develop a conscience, eh? Maybe. You'll have to ask him, provided he's not dead already. Kartag's a hard orc to know. I always thought he was a stone-hearted businessman, but then some horker out in the rift told me he was a big-time Covenant hero, so what do I know? It's a syndicate. A crime family. Everyone hoes them, from Tudreg Hood on up to House Counselor. If they put their thumb on a scale, you look away. If they tell you to pick something up, you snatch it up quick and thank them for the privilege. Trust me, dangerous is an understatement. I'd kick Maroon's Dagon in the rocks before I'd talk back to the Kamana Tong. I played dead. Performance of a lifetime, if you ask me. Well, I guess those acting lessons weren't so useless after all. My mother wanted to make sure I was well-rounded. I play a mean flute, too. Wait, why are we talking about this?
aid me!
Thank you. Come down from there, slave! Unless you prefer to lose some fingers.
No. You will not be in chains again. No one will.
From the side!
Thank you, stranger. I was near to slitting my own wrists. If it's to be slavery or suicide, I'll take suicide. Kartag told us to run. There was much shouting and confusion. Mobkir and Wiwaska ran one way, and I ran the other. I hope they fared better than I did. Those dry-skinned hoodlums almost killed me. Difficult to say. Slaves are a valuable commodity. I suspect they would either kill us outright or sell us back to our previous masters. The sum we paid to Kartag was meager. Too meager for the Kimona Tong, anyway. They will not take us home. Far less than he deserved. A turtle heart beats in Kartag's chest. Hard on the outside, but soft on the inside, you see? I hope he has not come to harm. Thank you, stranger. I will find Nakul. Hist protect you.